starts now. A former River Road teacher and coach is officially charged with sexual misconduct with students. Thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Jordan Lucero. Kelly has the night off. 32-year-old John David Bryan is facing 6 counts of improper relationship between an educator and student. That's a second-degree felony. River Road launched an internal investigation last month after they heard the accusations. Then the Potter County Sheriff's Office got involved. Bryan was put on leave at that point. He is no longer employed with the district. Sheriff Brian Thomas says both of the victims were adults. The Potter County Sheriff's Department has a warrant out for Brian's arrest. As of right now, he has not been taken into custody. A local charity finds themselves millions of dollars in the red, and now the state's launched an investigation. According to meeting documents, Panhandle Community Services has a budget of about $30 million. It uses that money to help people in our community with things like paying utility bills and getting food and affordable housing. Now that funding may be in jeopardy if the PCS board doesn't learn how to handle it correctly. An audit by the Texas Department of Housing and Community Affairs can't find where Panhandle Community Services spent $400,000 and was, quote, unable to come up with answers. This according to the board meeting minutes from earlier this month. Auditors say PCS also misspent as much as $533,000, which it may be forced to pay back. The minutes suggest the mistakes may have come at the hands of a disorganized board, saying warning signs existed, but that the board never received or requested necessary information to take care of $30 million businesses with policies which are not adhered to. Document from PCS's board meeting do suggest ways to restructure the organization, including buying new financial software or training their board members. We called PCS to try to get some clarification on what would be done to reorganize, but messages to its main office here in Amarillo haven't been returned. According to the minutes, an official told the board that funding from the state could be in jeopardy if PCS can't shape up. In the minutes, the board's executive director says she thinks that PCS could be reformed by June, but again, because our calls were not returned, we couldn't ask about the plans to do that. A major insurance company is closing the door of their Amarillo headquarters. Nationwide made that announcement today. They'll shut down their Amarillo office in July of next year. The move will leave 325 people without a job, most of them customer service representatives. Nationwide says it's a cost-saving measure. They say the building needs too many upgrades for technology and infrastructure. A federal grand jury indicts 2 people in connection with the death of an illegal immigrant whose body was found in a ditch near Vega 2 years ago. Demi Munez and Luis Asantuno were charged with conspiracy to conceal, harbor, and shield illegal immigrants. The Office of Homeland Security says the two were transporting a number of illegal immigrants from Houston to Los Angeles when Juan Jimenez Tovar was having some sort of medical problem caused by his diabetes. Court documents say the suspect simply dropped Tovar on the side of the road. He was found in a ditch at a rest area near Vega. An autopsy showed Tovar died from complications of pneumonia that was worsened by his diabetes. The medical examiner says he would have lived had he been given medical treatment. Amarillo police say the man whose body was found behind an Amarillo auto parts store yesterday died of natural causes. Special Crimes was called out to the AutoZone store just yesterday afternoon when a groundskeeper found the corpse. A suspicious death investigation was launched, but autopsy results back today showed the man died from an illness. Police say the victim has been identified, but they're waiting to notify his next of kin. One of the men indicted in connection with the death of an Amarillo man has reached a plea deal with federal prosecutors on separate drug charges against him. Charlie Sutton Webb was facing 7 drug charges today. He pleaded guilty to possession with intent to deliver. Webb was arrested and indicted earlier this year with Philip Schindler and Juan Svensson on those charges. Webb and Schindler are also facing tampering with evidence charges in connection with the death of Clay Peterson. Peterson was found dead on the side of an Amarillo road last year. Webb will be sentenced on that charge in June. Switching gears, now we're going to get a quick check of our weather. Here's Chief Meteorologist John Harris. So what's happening, John?
Well, Jordan, thank you very much. Can you imagine a hailstone the size of an apple? That's what's been falling between Floydada and Matador. Now this thunderstorm is rolling into southern Caddo County. It is severe. under a severe thunderstorm warning until 9:15 for eastern Floyd County and for Caudle counties. Again, the main threats will be hail up to the size of half dollar, strong winds, and locally heavy downpours. Also, we have some rain moving into Amarillo. It is light, but there is some lightning from time to time. Temperatures are cool. We're sitting in the 50s and 60s right now, 58 degrees in the city of Amarillo. What kind of weather can we expect for tomorrow and for the weekend? I'll let you know in a few minutes. Listen it back over to Jordan.
All right. Thank you, John. We've been talking about all week about that deadly tornado that touched down in Woodward over the weekend. Six people died during the storm. City officials say warning sirens didn't fire because lightning may have hit one of the towers, disabling some alerts. But as KCIT Fox 14's Morgan Shutters reports, weather experts say those sirens should never be your only line of defense.
It's the sound that sends chills down your spine, the warning to take cover. But they're not meant to be heard indoors and should never be your first defense against a tornado.
The outdoor warning system is meant to be heard outdoors.
It's so critical for people to take those basic steps to make sure that they are prepared. Have a NOAA weather radio, have a plan.
And the tornado that hit Woodward, Oklahoma was at night. Their only surefire indoor warning was a weather radio.
I have family that lives in Woodward, Oklahoma, and I would hate to think that they were dependent upon listening to those sirens before they took action to protect themselves.
But if this system should fail, there are two backups. However, Emergency Management and the National Weather Service also warn no home in Tornado Alley should be without a certified NOAA weather radio.
We believe that NOAA weather radios should be just as common in homes and businesses as fire alarms.
Some city officials even find outdoor sirens are ineffective. For instance, Starbucks says San Antonio and Lubbock do not have any. In Amarillo, Morgan Shutters, KCIT Fox 14 News at 9.
And Amarillo City officials are warning the Balmar siren is not working right now. There are four other sirens that will cover that same area. In the meantime, that tower should be up and running again in 6 weeks. Signs of downtown revitalization can finally be seen. Today, demolition began on 6th and Pierce. They're tearing down the old police station and old city jail. It's the site of the proposed downtown hotel. You'll remember the city had planned to break ground on a lot of new construction this spring, but those plans have been pushed back amidst contract negotiations. The fallout from the Secret Service prostitution scandal continues. It's already cost three agents their job. Today, the chairman of the House Committee on Homeland Security spoke out. Hear what he had to say next, but first, let's check back in with John.
Thank you very much, Jordan. Once again, we have a little bit of severe weather in our southern counties. We'll check it all out on Titan. After the break.